Alright, welcome back to Sports Chat.
503.
Now this one is what we are all here for. Football! Finally, some mother effing football.
Yep.
God, it's been a long time.
I think college football is the best sport out there.
By far. It's easily my favorite.
Yeah.
Season tickets at Autzen. My fam goes to all of them.
Yeah.
We love it, dude. It's like, it's the best.
Yep. Shout out to UND Fighting Sioux hockey team. Check it out, baby. The Fighting Sioux.
Fighting Sioux, baby.
There's at least two or three people watching that'll dig on that.
They're like, what? They're like, I thought the Native Americans had all their land taken. they still have a college?
Nah, they're still fighting for
they're
it.
They're fighting. They're the Fighting Sioux. They're not the agreeing to treaty Sioux. Okay, so check it out. College football. Yo, we're finally here. Let's do this. Real quick recap. Last year had a great run for Oregon. Masoli was under fire early on. They caught fire in a bottle, blah, blah, blah. Had the running game.
Yeah.
Ran over that dude in the Beav game on the fourth down play.
That
and then
awesome.
Kenyon Barner got the fourth down play, got to the Rose Bowl, and then got steamrolled by a very freaking good Pac-10 challenger of
Ohio State.
The fucking big
Pryor.
That Big Ten is a machine, buddy. I got a lot of respect for the Big Ten. So we represented the Pac-10 to the fullest last year. I think we can do it again this year, Oregon fans. I think we can do it. Now let's go through this schedule really quick. This is the first time we've looked at this schedule for this year. Done a sports chat on this bad boy. We start off with a huge New Mexico Lobos.
Yeah.
What is a Lobo?
Lobo's it's like a kind of coyote, I think.
Oh.
Yeah, it's like a kind of wild dog, I guess.
Something that you don't want on your property.
That's right. Yeah.
You don't want them around.
Yeah, they run in packs.
Okay, well, that's our first game. It's a home game, and I think that's a victory. I think it's a victory. I think it's an easy victory. I think the running game crushes. LaMichael's going to be suspended for the first game.
Just the first game?
Yeah, just first game. Masoli's suspended for the whole year, and he might be playing for UNLV.
No shit, really?
Running revs, dude.
Yeah, dude, that's
okay.
Funny, man.
So, first game, I think is important. I think get it off the books. I think people are just going to be absolutely blasted at Autzen. They're going to be absolutely out of their minds.
Yeah.
I think it'll be a nice day. 2 o'clock start. Okay, the big one, or maybe I don't even know. They haven't announced it. Maybe later. The big one is this though. Tennessee. We go down to the SEC.
The post Lane Kiffin
era. Yeah, exactly. And I think we put a huge whooping on the SEC. Now, UCLA went down there last year and won, and we beat UCLA in the second half, you know. But UCLA went down there and won last year. I think we're a better team than UCLA last year.
Yeah.
I think Oregon gets a victory. I would love to see this bring in serious, serious recruits for the next 2 or 3 years.
Yeah, I think they got Tennessee at Tennessee. And it'll be nice, too, because you're going to have all the early season hype of, oh, the SEC is, you know, going to be tearing ass again.
Right.
And you'll have the Ducks come down there.
But they play in the South Division there? They have the East or West or North or South. They play in the Florida Division.
Yeah.
And they're probably the fourth best team. Fourth or fifth best team.
Yeah, they're not that great.
No. But you know, they can surprise people.
You never know. Yeah.
It's still SEC, and the SEC kicks ass.
Yeah.
Now, my point about Tennessee, though, that I really like is that they have the creamsicle orange, which is like a melted creamsicle in your hand where it's like the vanilla has entered into the orange on the outside, made it a little bit softer orange. And we like to have that really nice, like, pumpkin orange that Oregon State to beat on.
Yeah.
So it'd be kind of sweet to go down and get a different shade of orange to
taste.
That's good, man. Okay, the next one is we come back for Portland State. The next one is we go to Arizona State. Open the season at Arizona State. That's a big game. What do you think about that?
Arizona State was not too shabby last year.
That's a tough place to play down there.
Yeah, Sun Devil Stadium.
Tempe.
Man. Yeah.
You been there?
Yeah. And so it's, I think the Ducks will be able to win over them, but yeah, you got to be careful.
And down there has been some shootouts. I mean, Oregon fans know about all the history there in Arizona State. It's been wild.
Yeah.
That'll
be an interesting game.
That will be. Come back for the first home game of the Pac-10 schedule is Stanford.
Yeah.
Think about Stanford. Great quarterback, but you don't have the stud running back anymore.
Yeah, it's Toby Gerhardt. Yeah.
But you got luck, and that guy is for real.
Yeah, I think Stanford's not going to hold up to Oregon, though, because They're not going to have the 1-2 where they're going to have a
running
game.
Still real big, though. They're real big. They're kind of like Notre Dame back in the day where they had those 300s across the board. They're just big. They're bulky.
Yeah.
Lines, all that kind of stuff.
Man, I think Oregon will be a win. What about
tough games. Lost them last year. The year before that, had to win at the end at Autzen. I think Oregon does beat Stanford this year, and I think Oregon beats them by a touchdown or two. Go up to Washington State. Love beating the hell out of them up in the Palouse, especially after the years of Washington State being good. Remember, people, Washington State used to be good.
Yeah.
For real. And Oregon State, Oregon always had trouble in the Palouse.
Yeah, they had Ryan Leaf.
Who was, again, one of those perfect examples of college and the pros are totally different leagues.
Yeah.
Okay, come back after that. UCLA is the big one for me. It's the middle of the schedule. The replay was on the radio today, and the Ducks struggled in that first half and got that big run from Kenyon Barner to start it, second half, and then got that LaMichael James spin and turn, that 50-yarder that was awesome. And really kind of stunned the Bruins. The Bruins had really good defensive tackle and a linebacker. Both went to the pros, and I think that you're going to have a situation where they're going to be a little bit looser coming up into Autzen, anything goes kind of mentality. That could be a sneaky game. That could be a tough game.
Yeah, that could be a tough game.
And I think that's the night game. That's a 6 o'clock one, yeah.
Yeah, yeah, that could be a tough game. And they've got...
Just sneaky. It's one of those games I don't feel that great about.
Yeah, and they've got USC the next week.
Yes.
So you hope they're not looking past
at USC,
UCLA.
And again...
And looking at USC.
Yeah. And again, the way I look at Oregon and USC is they are the two teams right now. So I think that really do think that when you get close to that on the schedule, the USC looks ahead to Oregon that 1 week, and Oregon looks ahead to SC that week. That could be dangerous.
Yeah.
Go down to SC. What do you think about at SC?
SC's going to have some...
They're going to have a weird year.
Yeah, it's going to be strange. Like,
they could get ass.
Like, yeah, don't get it twisted. This is USC football.
Yeah, they could kill. They could kill.
They've got studs there. They've got guys that have been there for a couple years. They're juniors or seniors.
New system, though. New system.
Yeah, but they got like guys that are juniors or seniors that are...
Oh, bona fide NFLers.
They could care less who the coach is.
Bona fide NFL.
Yeah, they're all about... kicking ass at SC football.
Yep.
And so
and getting that pro check.
Yeah. Yeah. So I mean it's gonna be and it's at SC, which they do it up pretty good. They do the fanfare there at
the night before that's the night before Halloween. I like the Ducks' chances. It's always tough playing down there. It's kind of a feast or famine. We either win by a couple or get blown. Both those weeks are dangerous for me. Other than that, I like this one. Come back for the Dogs at home. That's gonna be a hell of a game. Beat the shit out of the Dogs.
Huck the Fuskies.
Huck the Fuskies, baby. And then the next one is at Cal. That one scares me a little bit. I hate playing at Cal. What do you think about Washington, Cal?
I think Washington, the Ducks, will be able to win it. Washington, I think, probably, in my opinion, maybe behind USC, might be the biggest contender for the Ducks this year.
Yeah, see, I think Washington's all talk. I think that everybody wants to make Locker out to be the greatest, this, that, and the other. I think the Huskies are going to be the fourth or the fifth best team in the league.
Wow.
They're going to get beat by the Huskies, but beat by the Beavs, maybe.
Yeah.
Okay.
And then Cal, that's another tough one. It's at
tough
Cal.
One. At Cal. Always hard to play. Always hard to play down there.
But I think they'll be able to take care of Cal
now,
down there.
Arizona comes back home to Eugene. We beat them in Eugene, and then last year with the crazy game.
Yeah.
Last year, just absolutely nuts. Bottles being thrown in the cheerleaders, all that stuff. Duck fans know all about this kind of stuff. Just chaos. All those fans came down. We just fucked those kids. But tough one because, again, it's that week before you're going to look at the Arizona, look ahead to Oregon State
Civil
game
War.
A little bit. Civil War at Corvallis. Kind of tough one. I like Oregon in this one. Again, for me, the way I look at this whole schedule, I like Oregon to win every single game. The two games that I think are dangerous are the SC game down there and the UCLA game the week before at Autzen. Other than that, I like them to literally not beat them like they did 2 years ago at Corvallis, but put about a 10-point whooping on them and beat their ass.
Yeah, I'm looking at SC, and then I think the sleeper, like the scary one that scares me, is the Washington, like I said. But,
love the Washington game. I think the Washington game is going to be absolutely boxed.
Yeah, man.
Gonna
it's
going to be fired
be
up for that one.
So is the Civil War even going to be, is it going to be a contest? Or
Civil
is
War,
it...
no, I think Ducks are going to win that one, but I think the Beavs are going to be maybe the third or fourth, maybe fifth best team this year. They're going to have some troubles.
Yeah.
So I look at it this way. I look at it as Rose Bowl or Holiday Bowl for the Ducks. It's got to be number one or number two. If it's number three, it's a disappointment. Yeah. What do you think?
Yeah, I think it'll be number one. I think they'll be able to get by. Because later in the season against Lane Kiffin's SC, I don't think that they're going to... I think the Ducks, with their experience, will be able to get past them.
I think so, too. All right, Addicted to Quack, this one's for you guys. Duck fans across the world, unite. Peace.